Good afternoon. I'd like to welcome all of you to the Endicott College Doctoral Hooding Ceremony. Steve Jobs, the co-founder of Apple, said, quote, "Have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become," end quote. Today, we gather together to create a space of honor and appreciation at this hooding ceremony for those who have had this kind of courage and who did the hard work and research to receive their doctorates and further become who they intend to be in the world. Creator of life, please bless them and all who have supported them to fulfill this incredible accomplishment. We look forward to the contributions that they will make and the better world that they will create. Amen. Good afternoon, everyone. Well, let's try that one more time. Good afternoon, everyone. This is a celebration. We have a celebration, yes. My name is Sarah Quay. I'm the provost here at Endicott College, and it is my true honor to welcome our doctoral candidates seated in the front rows, dissertation advisors and chairs seated on the stage, trustees, faculty, families, and friends to this very special event. This afternoon, we gather to celebrate our students who have successfully met all requirements for the awarding of the doctoral degree in the disciplines of applied behavior analysis and education. In addition to the awarding of the doctoral degree at tomorrow's commencement, today we recognize the exceptional accomplishments of our doctoral students through a traditional doctoral hooding ceremony. I am now proud to introduce Dr. Stephen DeSalvo, President of Endicott College.
Thank you, Dr. Quay. Congratulations. It's a big day. I was reflecting back 23 years ago when I received my doctorate, and my children were 6, 7, and 9 years old. I remember writing my dissertation while I was attempting to finish the basement in the home we just bought. I was commuting into New York at the time from Connecticut, and the day I defended, one of my readers said, "We think your last chapter is exceptionally well written." And I said, "Thank you. I'd like it to be noted for the committee that the entire chapter was written on Metro North Railroad." And I wasn't kidding. I would write a page on the way in and I'd edit the page on the way home. We juggle many, many things during this process. And I know this is a big, big deal for all of you. So congratulations. It's an arduous path. You have worked very hard, and the folks up here have walked along that same path, so they know what it's like. So on behalf of everyone here, I want to extend congratulations. We gather to honor not just the knowledge you've gained, but the academic milestones you've achieved and the boundless possibilities that lie ahead. More than ever, our world is in need of your brilliance. The rise of artificial intelligence certainly presents new challenges and opportunities in global history, and opportunities in labor, and in education, and in scholarship. And this is now your new world to navigate, a world that can be frustratingly immobile in some areas and seemingly unstoppable in others. But AI does not, nor will it ever, replace critical thinking. It cannot collect evidence and make sound judgments based on that evidence. It cannot connect face to face with someone experiencing pain. And it certainly cannot replace the empathy we feel for our friends and strangers and other intrinsic facets of humanity. Technology can enhance powerful ideas, but it will never replace thinkers, teachers, writers, and makers who can ignite our minds. The explorers of thought and bearers of insight who possess the audacity to question the status quo and the tenacity to uncover new ideas. The knowledge you gained here, coupled with your singular personal experiences, will help guide you in the face of our changing world. So while earning your doctorate may seem like a culmination, it is also a springboard propelling you toward what lies ahead. We eagerly anticipate witnessing the paths you carve, the impact you make, and the lives you touch. So today, we celebrate you. We renew our unwavering commitment to you as members of our Endicott family, supporting not only your past achievements, but also the journey that awaits you. So on behalf of the Endicott College Board of Trustees and our entire community, I offer our heartfelt congratulations once again. Thank you.
Thank you, President DeSalvo. We will now begin the doctoral hooding ceremony for two of Endicott's doctoral programs, the Doctorate of Philosophy in Applied Behavior Analysis and the Doctorate of Education in Educational Leadership. Each doctoral candidate will be called to the stage by their advisor or dissertation chair, who will read the candidate's dissertation title and share a brief reflection on the work. The advisor or chair will then have the honor of placing the academic doctoral hood, a gift from Endicott to the candidate, over the head of the graduate, signifying their successful completion of the program. Doctoral hoods are lined in the colors of the academic institution conferring the degree. The Endicott doctoral hood is therefore lined in blue and green. The trim of the hood is a wide velvet band, the color of which indicates the academic area in which the doctoral degree is held. For instance, the Doctor of Philosophy is dark blue, and the Doctor of Education is light blue. Doctoral hoods differ from the bachelor's and master's hoods in that they are much longer, have a wider velvet edging, and expose more of the lining. We will begin with the candidates for the PhD in Applied Behavior Analysis. Dean of the Institute of Applied Behavioral Science, Dr. Mary Jane Weiss, please come to the podium.
Thank you, Dr. DeSalvo and Dr. Quay. I'm honored to begin the hooding ceremony. Candidates for the PhD in Applied Behavior Analysis, please come to the stage when your advisor calls your name. Kristen Bowman, evaluating the effect of physical prompts on echoic responses. Kristen is a speech and language pathologist and a board-certified behavior analyst and is passionate about her commitment to both fields. Her dissertation focused on identifying how verbal imitation skills can best be taught to children on the autism spectrum. Kristen has devoted herself to finding effective training procedures to build collaboration skills in behavior analytic practitioners and has already contributed extensively to the research literature and to clinical practice. I look forward to seeing her build more bridges across disciplines and to building soft skills in ABA practitioners. Rebecca Lee, talk aloud problem solving for BACB exam prep. Rebecca Lee is also a speech and language pathologist and a BCBA who is passionate about many things, including effective instructional procedures, both for the learners we work with and for our students of behavior analysis. While here, Rebecca contributed to the department in innumerable ways, becoming our primary tutor and a within-department expert on exam prep. Her dissertation brought together her research interests in effective instruction and her commitment to maximally and compassionately supporting students. Her work in higher education, as well as in autism intervention, is already making an impact on the field. Sheila Click. Standardization, the evaluation of single subject research. Sheila is a student who transformed a great deal while in the program, deepening her conceptual understanding, leading her to new research initiatives and higher level clinical analyses. Her dissertation focused on the development of a tool to evaluate the strength of the method sections of single subject research designs. Through the project, Sheila learned the deep intricacies of planning and executing a research project focused on tool development and contributed to the science in ways that could help the evaluation of manuscripts, the training of students, and the consumption of research findings. Calandra Plattner, Feasibility and Effectiveness of Foundational Motivational Interviewing Training with Behavior Analysts. Today I'll be reading the words of Cynthia Anderson, Callie's advisor and dissertation chair who couldn't be with us here today. Here's what she said about Callie. Working with Callie has been an absolute joy. She is brilliant, inquisitive, kind, and collaborative. In the 20 plus years I have had the honor to mentor doctoral students, she is a shining star. Congratulations. Dr. Justin Leaf, please come to the podium.
Shannon Arthur, a comparison of staff training procedures to teach flexible prompt fading. If you were to ask me what characteristics make a quality doctoral student, I would say hardworking, dedicated, critical thinker, and compassionate. Shannon has all of these qualities, which is why she was such a wonderful student to work with. I look forward to seeing her start her next chapter of her amazing journey. Amy Buxman, utilizing the teaching interaction procedure to train special education teachers in behavioral artistry. There are times you work with students and you know one day they will be the next leaders of the field. This is the case for Amy. She has every quality you would want to see in a behavior analyst, and I'm sure one day, very, very soon, she'll be considered one of the premier leaders of our field. Jill Hickey, training parents of infants to use contingent vocal imitation. It has been such a pleasure being able to work with Jill over the past 3 years. The research she has conducted on teaching parents how to better interact with their children is remarkable, not only for a doctoral student, but for any level researcher. I truly believe that one day she'll be on the Mount Rushmore of research in this area. Amy, Jill, and Shannon, congratulations. My research lab's gonna miss you so very much. Let me introduce Dr. Peter Gerhardt. Please come up to the podium.
Natalie Driscoll. Teaching safety domains to students of applied behavior analysis. Finding the balance between promoting independence and minimizing risks for adults with disabilities. I am proud and honored to be here to participate in Natalie's hooding ceremony. Natalie was an exceptional student who continues to demonstrate a sort of quiet confidence, caring, and talent. She is thoughtful, opinionated, and equally important, takes what she does very seriously while not taking herself very seriously. It has been my honor to work with you, Dr. Driscoll. Thank you. Brian Mason. I am again pleased and honored to be here in support of Brian Mason's ceremonial hooding. Brian, for those of you who don't know him, truly believes and acts in ways that support inclusion, value, and equity for all his students across educational systems. His dissertation demonstrated his commitment to using behavior analysis to understand and modify complex systems of behavior in support of similarly complex learners. Brian is knowledgeable, talented, dedicated, and thoughtful, and I am proud to have been even a small part of his doctoral journey. Congratulations to both of you. Dr. Jill Harper, please come to the podium.
Harris Dodds. Momentary time sampling, an examination of variations, interval length, and applied factors. Eris, you truly embraced the journey of pursuing this degree. When you found something interesting, you followed it through experimentation, exploration, with a focus of clinical application. Your dissertation serves as an excellent example of this balance. I look forward to seeing your future contributions to the field through research and practice. It was a pleasure taking this journey with you, and I wish you the best of luck with your next adventure, near or far. Congratulations again, Eris. Now let me introduce Dr. Robert Putnam. Please come to the podium.
Nicole Similac. Using applied behavioral analysis to strengthen academic engagement in a Kenyan institutional setting. Nicole Similac's impressive research was on improving the quality of life of street children in Kenya. Her vision, and this is a quote right from her dissertation, was to rescue children from dangerous situations, equipping them mentally, emotionally, and spiritually for the long-term success at home with their families. The impact of your research in this area could change lives of many children and adolescents in third world countries. Finally, let me say, I've been to a lot of dissertations defenses, but very few actually moved the participants to almost tears. You did that, and that was the power of your work. Congratulations, we will now hood the Doctor of Education candidates. Merritt Harper Rose, Dean of Education, Dr. Aubrey Thirkell, please come to the podium.
This year we have a small but mighty cohort of doctoral candidates receiving their degree. Between Melanie Tarbucks and Joseph Traggart, they have decades of experience and interest spanning social-emotional learning to digital literacy that promises to change us all. Their work promises to continue to shape the field for years to come as we continue to support our students holistically and fight disinformation. Congratulations to our new doctoral recipients. We are so proud of you. Candidates for the EdD in Education, please come to the stage when your advisor calls your name. Dr. Sarah Quay, please come to the podium.
Joseph Traggart. Analyzing Information Literacy Skills in Marketing Department Learning Outcomes, a Pilot Study. Joe, the last time we stood next to each other on a stage was at our undergraduate graduation. I recently dug out the program from that commencement, and there we are, Quay, followed by Traggart, end of the alphabet as always, in the Scholars of the College section. Who would have expected those many years ago that we would be together on yet another stage, this time to celebrate the completion of your doctoral degree. It has been an incredible honor to serve as your dissertation advisor and to stand with you once again, older and wiser, on this momentous day. I know your research will inform your own work and the work of higher education in the increasingly important field of information literacy. Got caught up in the moment. I invite Dennis Camacho to the podium.
Melanie Tarbox. Her dissertation titled High School Teachers Supporting Social and Emotional Well-Being of Their Students, a Practice-Based Approach. Melanie Tarbox's intentions resonated with me as social-emotional learning, SEL, pre-K through 12, known also as soft skills, are vital at various levels. I was intrigued to not only guide Melanie across the finish line, but to learn from this experience as a higher ed expert. Melanie did a wonderful job of producing contemporary qualitative research that helps advocate for growing teacher capacity on addressing the social emotional learning needs at the pre-K through 12 level. And she did so during a little thing called the COVID-19 pandemic, mind you. Melanie's research has and will continue to inform practice. And this being my first role as a chair, I was truly honored to be a part of her journey. Congratulations, Melanie. I now invite Dr. DeSalvo to the podium.
Congratulations to all our doctoral candidates. I look forward to seeing you walk across the stage tomorrow at commencement. Endicott has an academic award to recognize an outstanding dissertation completed by a member of the graduating class. Candidates from all doctoral programs were nominated by chairs and advisors and advanced for the review to the Advanced Graduate Council. The winner of the Doctoral Dissertation Award will also deliver brief remarks at tomorrow's commencement ceremony as a representative of all graduate students, serving as a role model to the entire academic community. I ask Dr. Justin Leaf to join me as the advisor to the winner of the Doctoral Dissertation Award for the dissertation titled Training Parents of Infants to Use Contingent Vocal Imitation. Congratulations on completing your outstanding dissertation, Jill Hickey.
To the doctoral candidates, I want to express my deep admiration for your achievements today. You've balanced your pursuit of the doctoral degree with your other commitments to work, to family, to friends. You've made sacrifices of time and energy in order to meet your goal of receiving your doctorate. My wish for you is that you now take this accomplishment and continue to achieve your professional goals with even greater confidence and conviction. Congratulations to each of you and to the class of 2023. Will the doctoral candidates please join us on the stage for a photograph with Dr. DeSalvo and Dr. Quay? Family and friends, please meet us in the Manninen Center of the Arts lobby for a reception to celebrate your monumental accomplishment. Thank you.
First year they let women into arts and science. Double eagle.